The airlines and the travel industry have taken a huge hit from the COVID-19 outbreak as thousands of flights around the world have been canceled.
Millions of travelers have changed their plans because of it. As a result, air traffic is down and the losses for airlines are stacking up. And at this point, no end in sight as we could face these concerns for weeks or even months. Joining us now to talk about all of this is Ian Petchenik from FlightRadar 24. You're with a website that monitors air traffic all over the world. So let's start with where this started in China and what we can learn just about air travel from how things went overseas.
Right. So China started to react by mass canceling flights in the third week of January. From the third week of January into February, flights were down about 61% in China. They've since started to rebound in the first week of March, but they're still way, way down. That's expanded to places like Italy that's just basically closed the country to business. So we're starting to see a huge drop off there as well.
I think what folks outside really want to know, regardless of where you're going, should you get on an airplane right now?
You should be prepared for taking care of yourself on an airplane in a confined space. Make sure that you're taking best practices as far as, you know, hand washing, don't touch your face, things like that. But airlines have really stepped up, and a lot of them have made a big push about how they're cleaning their aircraft.
Are they scrubbing down
every
once?
Yeah, things like that. Bringing out specialized cleaners and things like that as well.
We haven't seen this type of slowdown in the airline industry since 9/11.
Sure.
Do we expect the recovery to take just as long? I mean, these are big numbers of flights and big dollars for the airlines.
It certainly depends on how long there's a decline in air traffic. Mm-hmm. We've been using kind of the SARS 2002-2003 rebound as a benchmark, but the longer this drags on, it starts to become more of a 9/11 benchmark, and the length of time it takes air traffic to rebound.
Is there a difference between being on an air flight for 8 hours and being on a cruise ship as far as germs?
I'm no cruise expert, but anytime you're in an enclosed space, I think you want to take, you know, best practices as far as keeping yourself clean. Mm-hmm.
But we've seen the airlines have really dropped a lot of the fees that bug so many passengers, the change fees and whatnot, some of them a little slower to act than others, and that's giving travelers an opportunity to kind of beat the airlines at their own games when it comes to pricing, right?
Certainly. If you're interested in travel, there are good fares to be had out there. Airlines are trying to keep people in their planes and fly to as many destinations as they can. That becomes more difficult as this drags on and more planes are parked. But if you're apt to travel, there's some good deals.
And one might expect once things die down kind of about this virus, will the prices go right back up or maybe even higher so they can make up for what they've lost?
I think that you're going to see airlines wanting to keep planes as full as possible, especially as they bring capacity back. They've been parking planes. So there will be a period of time, I think, where airlines are recovering, but there's still, you know, ability to travel at a good price.
And if we can take the computer here, I'll show folks your website, FlightRadar 24, because it really shows you just how many planes are still in the sky despite the cancellations that we've seen.
Sure. Traffic in the U.S. especially is still at a nominal level compared to earlier in the year, but other places like China and Europe are starting to drop off, and I think we'll see a drop off in the U.S. in the coming days and weeks.
Well, life still has to go on. People have to do this and do that for work, so they're going to still do it while they can.
Certainly. I think there's going to be a base level of travel no matter what, unless there's a truly terrible scenario. But I think people will be flying less just because of the precautions that they're taking.
All right. Ian, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.